Hello students, today I am going to discuss about epidermolysis, and this is the category of the oxytocin. In last class I have discussed oxytocin, so it's a second category, ergoderivatives. It is also classified into three parts, that is ergometrin, methersine, cytometrin. So preparation, ergometrin 0.25 mg or 0.5 mg in ampoules it will be available, and 0.5 to 1 mg in tablet form it will be available. And second, methergine 0.2 mg in ampoules and 0.5 to 1 mg in tablets it will be available. And cytometrin, last class I have already told about this. Mechanism of action of ergoderivative drugs: it directly act on myometrium to stimulate the uterine contraction and decrease the bleeding. Indication, two indication are here, that is therapeutic and prophylactic. Therapeutic treatment we will discuss first, that why therapeutically it is used: to stop the atonic uterine bleeding when uterine tonicity will be decreased, so that time bleeding will be more occur. So prevent the more bleeding. To stop the bleeding we will give this derivative drug. When this condition occur, tonic uterine bleeding which is occurring during the delivery, it can be an abortion or expulsion of the hydrated foam mold. So that time we will use the ergoderivative drugs. Next, prophylactic use, that active management of third stage of labor. And second, prophylaxis against excessive hemorrhage following delivery, that time we will use the prophylaxis treatment. So contraindication, when we will not give this medication. So if patient having cardiac disease, severe preeclampsia and eclampsia, or maybe Rh negative mother, if mother is Rh negative, so in this condition we will not give this medication. Side effects, nausea, vomiting, BP can be increased with this drug, because this this increase the contraction, means muscle spasm is going to be increased in this condition. So that's why we will not give in BP case if BP is high. So interfere with lactation by decreasing the prolactin hormone. As you know, the prolactin hormone will be responsible for the production of the milk. So it will be decrease the prolactin hormone and interfere with the lactation. So gangrene can be happen. Routes of administration: route IV, IM, oral. So these are the actions. Ki agar hum isko medication, if we will give medication IV, so what is the duration of action of this drug? Means kitne time mein ye act karna shuru kar degi? So within a 45 to 60 second it will be act. Then methergine is a 1.5 minutes if we will give the IV. Then IM, if obstetrician will prescribe the IM medicine, so it will be work. If ergometry is going to give IM, so intramuscularly, so 6 to 7 minutes it will be act. In the same 7 minutes methadone also will act. And orally if we will give, it will be action jo aayega wo late aayega, because orally aap logo ne padha hoga fundamental of nursing mein, that IV agar hum dete hain, roots of medication administration you have studied in fundamental of nursing, or you are studying in fundamental of nursing. So in this, what happened, that IV medication which we are giving, that is direct into the blood, so it will be act so fast. If we give IM, so it will be not go to directly into the blood, but it will go to into the muscle. And oral it will not go to the directly muscle, but it will go to the esophagus. Then it will be absorbed in the between different parts. Okay, so it will be take time. So that is the 10 minutes of both drug. So prostaglandins, these all about the ergoderivatives. So prostaglandins act as a local hormone. Prostaglandins were first described by von Euler in 1935. It act as inflammatory mediators. Sources: prostaglandins are synthesized from one essential fatty acid, mainly arachidonic acid. Prostaglandin produce hota hai, ek fatty acid hota hai, arachidonic acid wahan se. Prostaglandins are widely distributed all over the body. It will be distributed in all over the body. Then third, in female these are identified in menstrual fluid also, endometrium, deciduum, and amniotic membrane also this form. Indication in which condition we can give this medication. So abortion, in abortion case, termination of molar pregnancy, induction of labor, acceleration of labor, management of atonic PPH, medical management of tubal ectopic pregnancy, and cervical ripening before the induction of labor for abortion. In this condition, we will give obstetrician administer this medication. Mechanism of action: it has oxytocin effects on pregnant uterus. Preparation: tablet dinoprostone. It will be come in form of dinoprostone, that is PGE2 0.5 mg, and vaginal suppository it come PGE2 20 mg, PGF2 alpha that is 50 mg, and vaginal pessary 3 mg PGE2, and then prostin E2 gel 50 microgram. Mesoprostol, it is important use also in MTP. PGF2 alpha is dinoprostone promethamine. That is PGF2 alpha is a dinoprostone promethamine drug is it. So contraindication: hypersensitivity, uterine fibrosis, cervical adenosis, PID, pelvic surgery, respiratory disease. In this condition, this medication not administered. Side effects: headache, dizziness, hypotension, nausea and vomiting, leg cramps, joint swelling can be occur. So till here we studied about the oxytocin, in which come ergo derivatives, oxytocin, ergo derivatives, and prostaglandin. These drugs are undergone oxytocin and which cause the uterine contraction or excite the uterine contraction of the muscles, uterine muscles. So this is the next drug, that is a different drug. It is a opposite. This drug action is opposite of the oxytocin drugs. Oxytocin causes the contraction and tocolytic drug causes the relaxation of the uterine muscle. So here we will discuss that it is also called anti-contraction medication or labor suppressant. Indications: to do prolonged duration of delivery, example preterm to prolonged labor, if mother having true labor pain, true labor in the before the term. So for stopping that pain, we will obstetrician administer this medication, and जिससे क्या होगा delivery जो होगी it will be come on time, जो at term है 37 weeks और 40 weeks उस time पे वो हो, ना कि 32-34 weeks में pregnancy हो जाए. So to postpone the labor, if अगर term की बात करते हैं, अगर ठीक है, अगर उसको contractions नहीं, अगर उसको proper है, तो हम labor को क्या करेंगे, postpone अगर हमें करना हो, ठीक है, या फिर कोई कुछ ऐसा उसको पहले से ही पेन शुरू हो गया. सेम चीज़ है अगर उसको प्री टर्म डिलीवरी हो रहा है या प्री टर्म उसको लेबर स्टार्ट हो गया, सो दैट टाइम वी विल पोस्टपोन द लेबर. सो ड्रग्स अंडर द टोकोलाइटिक ड्रग्स केम फर्स्ट बीटा मिमेटिक्स. जो बीटा मिमेटिक्स ड्रग है, अंडर दैट थ्री ड्रग्स कम आइसोप्रिन, बुप्रोटीन एंड टर्बुटालिन. कॉमन ड्रग यूज, टर्बुटालिन इज अ कॉमन ड्रग विच इज यूज टू रिलैक्स द यूट्राइन मसल्स during pregnancy. So mechanism of action, this drug, it act directly on the uterine muscle and vascular muscle for relaxation. Second drug is indomethacin, that is cyclogenase inhibitor. Cyclogenase is an enzyme which produces the prostaglandin. So uses early preterm labor associated with polyhydramnios. So in that case, obstetrician can be used indomethacin drug. So side effects: nausea, vomiting, constipation and dizziness is there. Mechanism of action is it reduces the synthesis of prostaglandin. Next, calcium channel blockers. In this, nifedipine is the game. These are the contractile protein. Nifedipine is an effective tocolytic drug. Uses during pregnancy, it can be used to prevent from premature labor, to prevent hypertension. Nifedipine आपने सुना होगा, normally अगर patient का BP high है या फिर eclampsia or preeclampsia condition है, that time also provide the nifedipine drug. So because जब contractions और जो oxytocin level है वो कहीं ना, जो oxytocin होता है वो कहीं ना कहीं क्या करता है, body में अगर ज़्यादा है उसमें ना artificial labor उनको हम देते हैं तो BP can be high. Tachycardia can be happen. So for maintaining that BP, we obstetrician administer the nifedipine drug. So during pregnancy, to prevent from premature labor, to prevent hypertension, preeclampsia, as I told you. So side effects same as Indomethacin syndrome, which side effect studied in previous slide, that nausea, vomiting, constipation, dizziness. So these are the side effects. And fourth is magnesium sulfate to inhibit the uterine activity in women in preterm labor for preventing preterm birth. So magnesium also give for this purpose. Then fifth drug is nitric oxide. It is used to during pregnancy to maintain a healthy flow of blood to the baby. So it is used in pregnancy bhi use hota hai, and ye isliye kyunki jo blood flow hota hai baby mein usko proper maintain rahe, ek healthy flow rahe, isliye nitric oxide provide kiya jata hai, administered kiya jata hai during pregnancy. So it's a isoprene drug which comes beta mimetic drugs. So first one is an initial phase and second is maintenance phase. So under the initial phase, if IV drip is given, so 100 mg in 5% dextrose mein isoprene denge, 100 mg denge aspirin IV drip mein, wo 5% dextrose patient ko IV drip 5% dextrose chal raha hai. And jo iska maintenance phase hai, that is IM 10 mg 6 hourly hum usko maintain karke rakhenge. To starting mein hum itna dete hain, itna amount mein 0.2 microgram per minute हम की रेट से उसको IV flow चाहते हैं. Infusion pump के through हम इसमें ये rate fix कर सकते हैं. So and orally if maintenance phase अगर IM हो गया, after that orally if patient आता है, orally tablet अगर patient को देते हैं, then 10 mg उसको देंगे और 6 to 8 hours भी उसको administered करते हैं. So side effects pulmonary edema, hypotension, nausea, vomiting, tachycardia, cardiac arrhythmias, hypokalemia and heartburn is there. So one drug is there, atosiban drug. So atosiban drug ko IV dete hain. This also used for during the pregnancy. So maintains the means jo oxytocin hota hai, vasopressin hota hai, unko inhibit karne ke liye. So it's the action of this drug. So contraindication when this drug will not administer to the patient. So in first one, severe pregnancy induced hypertension, eclampsia, preeclampsia, active vaginal bleeding, placental abruption and cardiac